What happens when there is no power? Your loads don't run, and that's when you start your DG. The same thing can be employed in an on-grid power plant. When there is an on-grid solar system, and if there is no power coming from the grid, your solar plant can still supply you power by switching on the DG. But you'll still need something called a DG sink, which is going to be explained in this video. Before we move into this topic, I would like to share some facts. A solar inverter, an on-grid solar inverter, will not generate any power if there is no reference voltage. If it is a three-phase inverter and if there is no reference voltage, or even on single phase, the inverter will still not generate any power because of its anti-islanding. There is a second fact about the DG. A DG installed in your industry or a factory or in your campus needs at least a 30% of load. You will get a good mileage on your DG when you run your DG at a minimum of 30% load. This is just like DG is another diesel engine. You have these speedometers in your car which says the economy speed. The engine can start at zero, but it's the economy speed where you will get the good mileage. So a DG has to run at a minimum of 30% on its load side to get a good mileage on the DG. When there is grid power, the solar inverter takes reference from the grid, starts generating power, pushes it into your load, and the excess is then pushed into the grid. And if there is no power in the grid, the solar generator can take a reference voltage from your DG and start generating power. But what happens if your load is fed? The excess power is then pushed into your DG, which can be harmful to the DG. DG cannot take any excess power into it. It can burn its alternator. This is why we install a DG sink. There are three parts involved in a DG sink. One is a bidirectional energy meter. Second is the actual DG sink device. And then the inverter itself. Now, you will have to tell the inverter when to start and how much to generate. Seeing to that, the DG is always given its 30% of load. This bidirectional energy meter standing here is sensing the output of the DG, and when the DG reaches its 30%, it gives a signal to the inverter to start. When the inverter starts generating, the DG need not run for excess load because the solar is taking over the excess load. Let me explain the same with an example. If your load is 80 kilowatt, the DG is of 100 and the solar plant installed is of 100 kilowatt. In this case, the DG has to run on its minimum load, that is 30% of load, which is 30 kilowatt. So 30 kilowatt of this load will be satisfied by the DG, and the remaining 50 kilowatt will be taken from solar, provided the sun is shining bright. If there is a cloud passing, or if the solar reduces its generation due to some external factors, then the DG will immediately ramp its power up. This is how DG synchronization works. DG is running on its minimum load and solar is taking over the excess load. You get a good mileage this way. For doing a DG sync in a solar on-grid system, the DG capacity should be equal or greater than the inverter's capacity. This is because, consider if the DG capacity is lower than that of the inverter. What happens is, if the load is a 100 kilowatt load and if your PV system is of 100 kilowatt but the DG is of only 30 kVA, the DG will still give a reference voltage to your solar plant and make the solar plant run. But solar can only be a secondary source. You cannot depend on solar energy. If there is a cloud passing, the solar power drops and then there is a overload on your DG, so that this system will collapse. So while doing a DG sync, the DG capacity always has to be equal or greater than that of the solar power plant. Secondly, there is one more question normally asked to me. Okay, I have a 1 megawatt of solar on-grid system. Can I run it by using a 100 kVA DG just by giving a reference? No, that's also not possible. The simple reason is again this. If you have a 100 kilowatt or a 1 megawatt of solar power plant, and if you have so much of load, yes, the solar plant can satisfy all your loads by taking reference from the DG. But what happens if the solar power drops? The load is constant. The load is always taking constant power from the source. So if the solar power drops, then the DG goes on an overload condition and it will trip. So it's always advisable to have the DG capacity and the solar capacity equal, or the DG has to be bigger than that of the solar inverter's capacity. Thank you.